Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Genetic Basis of Inheritance. In that, we are studying topic Test Cross. Now, Mendel did all his experiments and laid down various other laws. So, just to cross-check those laws, he did Test Cross. Let's study today what it is. Test Cross. Now, if I try to break that word, Test Cross means a cross that is used to verify different other laws. So, whenever Mendel did any experiment, whether it was law of incomplete dominance, codominance, law of independent assortment, he always did a test cross just to be sure about the genotype and the phenotype which he got in those experiments and just to gain a clarity. So basically, test cross could be said as a cross between the F1 hybrid, or you can say the F1 progeny, and the recessive parent, or you can say the homozygous parents. So for example, if the F1 progeny is capital T small t, then it would be crossed with a small t, or you can say homozygous or recessive parent. Now, why Mendel designed this test cross, the only reason he had was just to verify whether the unknown genotypes of a given plant. When we did the cross, there were certain genotypes and phenotypes which he imbibed or got. So just to verify or come across those genotypes, he did test cross. For example, if there's a plant, it can have capital T, small t, and capital T, small t, all three different genotypes. And these three different genotypes could assemble or hybridize in different manner to give a certain phenotypic. Now, Mendel did cross test just to verify what these different phenotypes could be and what would be the ratio of these different phenotypes. Test cross, a cross that is used to verify various outcomes in different laws did by Mendel on Pisum sativum plant or pea plant. Now, the definition of test cross goes a cross of the F1 hybrid, or you can say the F1 progeny, with that of the recessive parent, or you can say the homozygous parent. That's an example of test cross. Now, test cross, it was designed or it was used to verify the unknown genotypes, or you can say genotypes which were not confirmed and Mendel wanted to check them. For example, a given pea plant, or you can say a given Pisum sativum plant, can have any of this possible combination. It could be dominant tall, that is capital T. It could be heterozygous in nature, that is it has capital T and small t, or it could be homozygous in nature, and it will be dwarf, that is small t and small t. So Mendel did, just to find the genotype, he did test cross. the genotype could be capital T small t, or it is small t small t. Now if the genotype is small t, we can say that it would be visible in a plant, or you can see phenotypically or just with your eyes that the plant would be short or dwarf. But what in the case of capital T and capital T small t? We all know that they will show both same phenotype, that is they both will be dwarf. We know that the capital T is always dominant in comparison with the small t, and the capital T will be expressed in every case. So thus the given plant can be capital T small t, capital T capital T, and hence a test cross is necessary in every condition to verify the correct genotype. Otherwise we would never come down but to a conclusion that what the genotype would be. Students, in this part of the chapter what we came across was test cross, and how test cross was necessary if you have three options or three alleles which were homozygous, heterozygous and dominant. So Mendel did this crosses just to verify the genotypes in the case of dilutions of the genotype. I hope you are clear with this concept of test cross. Thank you.